There we go. We begin the real thing. I want to share with everyone around the world why I'm wearing black tonight and why I'm also wearing a purple, a silk black top and a purple stole. This stands for the Kingly Ministry of Christ. This also stands for reconciliation and for healing. But the black stands for the seriousness of my office. The black stands for the seriousness of my office. And it also stands for the fact that I weep for the problems and sins and sickness and poverty of the world. But there is a reason why I'm doing this tonight. Please, for heaven's sake, I'm begging whoever is making all those moves. If you are laying on your bed with a phone by you and you are moving around, move the phone away from you. I'm going to share with you something that is not very sweet. That is this. The year 2016 that we've entered is also called the year of death. There will be a lot of people who will leave the earth. And that's what I've been told. The earth is going to receive the bodies. Maxine of Victoria, can you tell that person who is making this noise to mute their phone, please? So that I can concentrate on what I'm doing. Please, every one of you, no matter who you are, except I ask you to talk, don't unmute your phone. Please mute your phone. Everybody, so that you can listen. Okay. It's a year of anger from the world of darkness. Let me ask somebody. There's somebody that doesn't know that they are affecting what I'm doing. Let me ask a question. Geneva, is your phone turn on mute?
My phone's always on mute.
Okay. Victoria, who is making those moves? There's somebody whose phone is very close to you. So every turn and twist you are making, we are picking it up.
My phone's muted.
Okay. I want everybody to mute so that you can listen. Listening, instruction is the gateway. In fact, instruction is receiving. So listen carefully. I do not want to lose the trend of what I'm doing now. The reason is what we are doing, there's a place I'm going to ask questions. And people are going to want to be ministered to. And when I lose the trend of my thought, you lose. For some people, what I'm doing is not important. But it's very, very important to me and to the world. So let's go back to what we are saying. it has been revealed to me that 2016 is the year of anger. The reason is because there have been things that the enemy thought that he has succeeded in doing. And he has discovered that the people of righteousness have moved ahead of him with Jesus. The judgment of God that is coming upon the earth during the second year of the Shemitah will also take out a lot of people through death. So death is gonna come from two sides. It's gonna come through the judgment of God for people whose cup has run it over with evil. Then the other one will be people who are not prepared to fight spiritual warfare, to fight for who they are, to stand their ground and not allow chance to play into their lives, but to be the one that will create the chance or chances. But those who are not willing to make those powerful moves, the devil will take them out. Yes, he will. So death will be coming from two sides. And I mourn for those people. I mourn for those people. Because there will be people who are not prepared, who are not listening to what I'm saying, who will be taken out. I do not want any of you to be taken out. If you are willing to obey instruction and let go of attitudes that does not help you, then you will not be taken out by the forces of destruction from both sides. Now let's ask the secretary to read for us about the spirit, because 2016 is called the year of the spirit. It has many names, and you need to memorize those names so that it will help you to know how to chart the course of history. The year of the spirit, which means it is the year that you have to communicate with the spirit realm, spirit to spirit. Please read to us the reading for tonight.
The reading for tonight is coming from 1 Samuel, the 16th chapter, the 1st through the 13th verse. And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long wilt thou mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Fill thine horn with oil and go. I will send thee to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided me a king among his sons. And Samuel said, how can I go? If Saul hear it, he will kill me.
Okay, stop there. Okay. You might have a king or a president or a leader, whether in a nation, in a company, in a business environment, in a religious organization, but that does not mean that there is a king on the throne. God has shown me that there is a famine of leaders. We have so much about leadership, so much degrees and studies, and yet when God look at the earth, there ain't much supernatural leaders in different fields or faculties of life. Husband, I look and I saw husband and wife, they are married. But in the supernatural, they are not married. Their marriages are not even registered in the supernatural. It's almost like they are shacking. There's no leadership in that marriage. God, there's no marriage in the first place. Many businesses are empty of leaders. Churches are empty of real pastors. Real pastors are rare. In the political world, real leaders are rare. They are not there. And God began to show me these things. See, there was a king in Israel named Saul. But in the supernatural, there was no king. God said he has already rejected him. So Israel was without a king. Yet there was somebody who was a king. That also happened in the time of Ahab. You see, in 2016, there will be an exposure of what is lacking. There will be a lot of interplay of the supernatural on the earth. The kind of prophetic life that we are used to will change because we are going to have what we call power prophecy or prophetic powers. It's not going to be somebody say a word over you and that is it. It's going to be that while the word is being spoken over you, the power comes upon you. Every word that will be spoken over you will be what we'll call creative word. I'm going to tell you what is going to be happening in my ministry. When I speak and I will say to God to create somebody's heart, new heart be created, it will go into effect. Because the word that I'll be speaking at that point will be spirit and life. And when it is spirit and life, it creates something. So in 2016, God wants you to begin to create. That's why, beginning from tomorrow, the phone line will jam. Because I am creating 2016 into you. And the fullness of it is going to be manifested beginning at Las Vegas conference on October 23rd. But it's on. Continue reading, please.
Said, take an heifer with thee, and say, I am come to sacrifice to the Lord. And call Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show thee what thou shalt do. And thou shalt anoint unto me him whom I name unto thee. And Samuel did that which the Lord spake, and came to Bethlehem. And the elders of the town trembled at his coming, and said, comest thou peaceably? And he said, peaceably.
Okay,
I am come to sacrifice.
Let me go in here. All these years, you've been the one struggling to find God. But from 2016, God will be the one coming to find you. You are not going to struggle. You are not going to live in church 5 days a week. You are not going to be sleeping in the church. Because I want you to get this. See, what we are doing, the open heaven thing we are doing now, is not what will end now. 2016 actually is an open heaven phenomenon for those who are sons and daughters of the kingdom. Most of 2016, the heaven will be opened for the sons of God. That is why next year is going to be easy for you. Now, let me say it. It was the first thing I wanted to say while before I was being interrupted. 2016 is going to be the easiest year for you to buy a house. Some years back, many of you did not know it. There was a satanic agenda against Christians buying houses, buying cars, having enough money in the bank. And that has been happening until last year that just ended yesterday. Look at go back and look at what I'm saying so that you really know that I'm a prophet of God. If you look at your life for the past 7 years, you will see how many of you bought houses, they went on foreclosure. Many of you bought cars, they were repoed. Many of you got married, it ended. And you had no idea that there was a satanic agenda against your house. There was a satanic agenda against your car. There was a satanic agenda against your children. Why? Because the heaven was hard. It was not opened. This is the year that buying a house is going to be easy for you. Maintaining a car is going to be easy for you. Being in a marriage is going to be easy for you. Finding a mate is going to be easy for you. Reason is that most of 2016, the heaven will be an open heaven. You've been told. You've been told. You've been told. Many of you will walk into a sudden anointing. You were not prepared. You were not prepared for certain show up of God. God suddenly show up. You were not prepared for it. But suddenly God showed up. Suddenly he showed up. Why? Because this is the year of the showing up. All these years, the devil has been showing up. But this year, God will show up. What we are doing right now, what we are doing right now is to stop the enemy from showing up in 2016 in your life.
Amen.
That's what we are doing. We are setting up the agenda of the kingdom before the enemy has the power to regroup, to set up his agenda. We've already finished our own. That's how it should be. I want you to shout, let fire burn in the camp of darkness. Begin to shout. Let fire from God burn in the kingdom of darkness. I want you to say this. Before January 1 comes, the wind of God has arrived for me already. Say it.
Before January 1 comes, the wind has arrived for me already. God has already arrived for me.
I wanted to repeat this word. Before January 1st come, God has taken care of my finances already. Say it.
January 1st come, take care of my finances already.
Before January 1st come, God has already arranged my life. I live high and easy life. Say it. Before January 1st come, God has already given me my car and my houses. Say it. Now let me tell you what is happening right now. There are people who thought that they were called to follow you. But from tonight, they will receive another call to leave you.
Amen.
They'll receive another call to leave you, and they are going to leave you. Because the witches that you thought were outside, they live right in there with you. So 2016, and the conference we are doing now, the wind is going to blow and they will feel uncomfortable. There are people who are going to be so uncomfortable with you that they will just leave. For no reason, they will just leave. So if your husband pack and go, don't worry. If your wife pack and go, don't worry. Continue reading.
Okay, and Samuel did that which the Lord spake and came to Bethlehem. I'm sorry, I already read that. And he said peaceably, I am come to sacrifice unto the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice. And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to the sacrifice. And it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab and said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart.
Okay, you stop there. Prior to this new year, people have used you, dump you, come back, recycle you, reuse you, and dump you again in the recycle bin and come back. The ghosts have been coming and going. But in 2016, it's not gonna be so. The reason is this. Excuse me. Many of you are going to, for the first time, you've been hearing about the anointing. You've been hearing about the glory. Because most of the time, during the year, the heaven will be opened. You will, for the first time of your life, be able to see a real angel face to face. Number two, you'll be able to, many of you will actually see Jesus come to visit you. That's number two. Number three, you will for the first time hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, not a whisper, a real audible voice of a human being. And you will think it's somebody, but the Holy Spirit will make you know that it is him. Many of you will be able to talk to angels for the first time, because everything, this is what God said to me, everything that I've been doing since 2012 has been to prepare a certain group of people for this new year. Seriously. He said the reason why he inspired me and provoked me to make many videos and pour into the internet was to prepare certain people by watching those videos for this new year, for this, for 2016, that he has been using that to prepare certain people to enter into a high class life. A high class life. Now, I will also tell you something else. There are many of you who have been mocked by your mother or father or brothers and sisters. They've mocked you. They've mocked you. They've told you, where is the money? You've been doing this, you've been doing that. You say you're born again, but where is your God? Where is the money? And let me share with you what's going to happen. The voice of the mockers will be silenced this year. The voice of those who mock you will be silenced. Those of you that either husband or wife or in-laws have been mocking you. They say you are no good. You can't pass your exam. They send you here for you to do this. You cannot do that. You're a bad mom. I am told to tell you that the voice of the mockers will be silent. Those who swore to hold your daughter or your son or your husband or your wife captive, the hand of the captor will be broken forever. Now, many of you will be told that you follow that crazy African pastor and that he has turned all of you into witches and wizards. And I'll tell you the reason. It's because 2016 was the year that it was written in the program of those people that they were supposed to kill you. So listen carefully. 2016 was a year that was put together a long time ago, that it will be the year that you will be taken out, because they knew that God's judgment will come to take people out and the rod of darkness will come to take people out. Therefore, your name was part of what was in that file. But what we are doing right now has broken their laws, and they are not happy about it. It has broken their laws. It has broken all that were written about you. Let me share something with you. Haven't you seen how many of you, you lost your marriage within the last 7 years? Have you not seen how you lost jobs? Jobs come and go. Jobs come and go. Have you not seen how your kids come and go? You get into quarrel with them, families, all of that. Is because each of these people were programmed to provoke you to either take your life or do something that will send you to jail. That was the program. That was the program. But the invisible hand has been guiding you up to this time. And now the program that they have for you has been dismantled, destroyed. That's what has happened. There are also many of you, if you have somebody who is in jail, something is going to happen in government in America and around the world that will make those people who are in jail for little or no reason, they will be asked to leave. And so it's going to affect members of your family. They are coming out. And so you have a job to do. You have a job to do. And this is the job. Your job is to reprogram those of your family who are coming out so that they join you and not join the people in the family that they used to join. That's what's going to happen. Have you not noticed that at any time you plan to start a business, it never works? And you have somebody to, you tell somebody to be your partner in business, it never works. You try to be in a relationship, it never works. It's because this thing we programmed a while back that you should not enjoy those things. Another thing why you didn't have money up till last year, 2015, is because there was a meeting that was held against you. And that meeting was that if they allow you to have the kind of money that you want, that number one, the earth will not be able to contain you. Because they know that you are a psychedelic lady. They know that you are a koi shoe lady. They know that you are, yeah. They know that you are a koi shoe lady. They know that you are a pump lady. They know that you are a queen. They know that you are a king. You are a prince and princess. They know that you will drive and pass the streets of where evil happened to you, and evil will vanish, because they will say, "Whoa, I know that person. Are you serious? Even after we did what we did against him or her, what has happened? Look at the kind of car that she's driving. Look at the kind of car that he's driving. Are you serious? Look at the kind of house that he or she is living. What has happened? 2016 is the year that you see, what you've been saying is now going to begin to happen. You have been saying, thou hast anointed my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Thou hast set a table before me in the presence of my enemies. That is what has begun to happen in 2016. Next thing I want you to know, jobs are going to be taken. Please, let's be quiet about this one. We don't want unbelievers to hear this one. I mean, I'm joking. Jobs, this is true. In 2016, please be prepared, because jobs and money is going to be taken away from some people, and it will be given to you.
Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. Many of you will come to work. You will come to your job, and you will be told to go to the supervisor or manager's office. Or to go to the president of the business need to talk to you. And you will say, I didn't do anything wrong. They said, no, it's not about you doing anything wrong. And you will walk in. This is what is going to happen next year. What is happening this? We have already entered next year now. And he will say, oh, go, welcome. Sit down. How are you? I read your record. Yeah, I know some of the things they wrote about is out of envy and jealousy. But I like your hustling spirit. I like your tenacity. I like the fact that you protect this business. Well, before you arrived, we have fired your supervisor, your manager. We fired her or we fired him. And we have decided that you go into that position. Go and run it well from now on. That's what is going to happen in 2016. Now, let me turn to family matters. Many of you, your family members do not regard you as anything. They don't talk to you. They don't really value you because they said you don't have money. You've not built houses for them. You've not bought them cars. And you should not. You shouldn't, because they are not qualified nor entitled to it. So listen to this. Listen to what I'm going to tell you. because of what they did to you, this is how God is going to revenge against those who mock you and against those in your families who look down on you and say, look at you, you've not achieved anything. Why should we? This is what God is going to do to them. Number one, the revenge of God is going to be this way. Prosperity. God is going to use prosperity to destroy those who hated you. It is your prosperity that is going to destroy them. You are not going to say a word. You are not going to fight them. You'll keep away from them, but they will smell your perfume from afar. They will smell your stew, the stew of your rice and beans from afar. They will smell your barbecue from afar. They will smell your fat bank account from afar. They will smell your Jesus and your power from afar. They will smell the success of your children from afar. And they will smell your car and the fumes of your car from afar. And what will happen will be that they will smell your fame from afar. And because they will not be able to stand your prosperity, therefore many of them will not be able to sleep. And because they won't be able to sleep, they will be so worried. So they will go to some places to look for help on how to destroy you. And when they go there, the person who runs the show will tell them, listen, I myself, I do not want to die. Therefore, don't come back. You see that door? Hit the door. Exit. Exit.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Yep, exit. And so many of them will have a heart attack. Many of them will have stress-related and what we call dumb and foolish-related sicknesses that comes as a result of anger, hatred, and envy. And so it will kill them. It will kill them. It will destroy them. And now let me tell you another thing that will be happening in 2016. Those of you who have children are part of this ministry. You are going to find a great change coming upon your children. And you will ask, how did this happen? Your children will automatically change. It's not because you are talking too much. You don't need to talk to them too much. You don't need to blame them. You don't need to do this, do that. No. Something, because of the open heaven of 2016 that will be ongoing, something in them will be awakened about your kind of God, because they've been making fun of you when you are praying. They've been making fun of you when you fast. Mommy, when will this fast end? Let's go and eat pizza. When are you going to come back from this church thing? Let's go to burger joint and have some food and so on. And you say, daughter, let me just finish. The fasting will finish at 6 o'clock. That same daughter and that same son will now begin to join you to fast and to go to church. That's what is going to happen in 2016.
All is well.
And now let me tell you something else that is going to be happening. For those of you who have teenagers who have just finished high school and they have their little secrets about what they are doing in secret, boys and girls things, your sons and daughters will begin to come to you to ask you questions that they have never asked you. And they will no longer blame you. They will see you as their teacher, their first teacher.
Wow, my God.
That's what's going to happen.
Beautiful.
In 2016. Now, there are certain people who have been raised for the past 14 years. The word is 14 years. There are certain people who've been raised the last 7 years. And God has been keeping these people in waiting for 2016. Now, these people, you don't know them. But in 2016, they will all begin to emerge from the shadow of this world. Their job, why they were sent to the earth, why they were born, was to help you. To prosper you and to help relocate you. To relocate you. And let me tell you, those people have been released as of yesterday. They have been released. Let me tell you about my own. You have heard me talk about that where I am. I can no longer use it for studio, for chapel, for this. Yeah. And I want to move to a better place. Well, God said, you are not moving too far because you like beauty. You want where you can breathe fresh air. You want where you can be watching the river as the people paddle by or drive they are using their motorboat or sailboat up and down the river. You want a situation that when you open your bedroom window, you can see the scenery of people and their boats. You can see the ducks and the geese in the water. When you open the balcony door of your house, of your living room, you'll be looking at the river. And I say, yes, that's what I want. He said, I'm going to give that to you. And today he gave that to me.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen.
Yes. Today he gave it to me. Yeah. So when the conference will be on, you will no longer be hearing people disturbing. You will no longer be hearing the voices of cars and trucks and this. No, done deal. See, that's what we are talking about. See, I told you that I've already entered 2016. Many of you were like, I've never entered a new year in September. But this is how it is. So by October, I'll be moving in. In fact, this evening, before I came to the meeting tonight, I walked to my new place, and I opened, and you know what I did? I went straight to the bedroom. Yeah, I went straight to the bedroom of the house. I went through to the bedroom of the place, opened the wind. In fact, when I reached there, the owners have already come, and they have opened they lifted up the curtain of the bedroom, and I just stood there, and you know what I was seeing? There were families in two boats sailing by. And they were just passing by, and one of them turned around. You know, there's big tall trees, and this is the water. And one of them turned around and was seeing my face there and waved at me, and I waved back. I just, it's just a thrill. And then I went to the balcony, opened the balcony door, stepped outside. And you know what I saw? The sun was just doing its last jump, and it was right on the water in front of me, and it just sparkling. I said, I need to bring my laptop and sit here and start writing. Because I told God I needed a place that will heal me and I can concentrate and write. And this is, see, 2016 is already on. It's on. Everything you need God, yeah, let me share this with you. Everything you want God to do for you in 2016, please make sure that when you will be doing the covenant in October, November, yeah, I think it will be the beginning of November when we will begin the covenant thing. Make sure you put it there, because I'm going to pick each covenant and stand before God and talk to him about. I'm not going to bring all of them into one place. I will pick as they arrive in the mail, because it's going to come through the mail. You're going to come through the mail with an offering. If you don't have an offering, just send it. It's going to come through the mail, and I'm going to pile it, and it's going to stay there until Easter. Until Easter Monday. Then I will put them into the prayer request place. And then when the prophetic begins again, I'll bring them. So we are going to have prosperity. We are targeting not many things. All that we are targeting this year is prosperity. It's prosperity. It's good things happening. In fact, by the time that we will be having another world conference, it will be a conference for you to come and dance. To be a conference for you to come and, even if you do not know how to dance, at least jump around. Do some march. Do some marching. Yeah, if you don't know, there was something I was seeing on, was it on Sesame Street? Yeah, on Sesame Street. And Elmo, was it Elmo or somebody was telling the cow to join him to dance. And the cow goes, "But you know that cows do not dance." Cows do not dance. He said, "Just move your feet this way. Just move your feet that way. Just wag your tail this way. Just move your tail that way." You see, you're dancing already. So at the end of this new year we've entered, we will be having a time to dance. To dance. Because one of the things that is going to make your enemies mad, in fact, they think that they are already insane. They have not yet started to be insane. They think that they are mad. They have not yet started to be mad. What is going to make them to be mad more than anything is our success, our winning, and our prosperity. And we are going to focus on those things.
Yes, Lord.
Now continue to read, sweetie. Continue to read, please.
Oh, sure. Then Jesse called Abinadab and made him to pass before Samuel. And he said, "Neither hath the Lord chosen this." Then Jesse made Shammah to pass by. He said, "Neither hath the Lord chosen this." Again, Jesse made seven of his sons to pass before Samuel. And Samuel said unto Jesse, "The Lord hath not chosen these." And Samuel said unto Jesse, "Are here all thy children?" And he said, "There remaineth yet the youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep." And Samuel said unto Jesse, "Send and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he come hither."
Okay, stop there. Stop there and mark where you stop.
Okay.
There are many of you for the past 7 years. There's a particular kind of job you've been looking for. That's what the Spirit of God is saying. You've been looking for a particular kind of job, no headache kind of job, no crazy people kind of job, no cheating, lying, snitching, bitching people kind of job. You know what I mean? No people betraying you kind of job. No people not recognizing your worth and celebrating your giftedness kind of job. You don't want it, because it's like every job you went into, there've already been a discussion before you even came into that job. By the time you have a job, it's like a decision was already made against you in that job. But thus says the Spirit of the Lord, the Lord will not sit down anymore and watch. The Lord is going to lead you by the hand. He's going to lead you by the hand into your lucrative and not permissive wheel job. He's going to lead you into stable, permanent, and perfect wheel job in the right location that will pay you 7 times more than you've ever been paid. Many of you in 2016, many of you will see the kind of money that you've never seen before.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Cool. Yes.
In fact, let me conclude the way it was said. There are many of you who are going to buy cars, cash. And there are many of you who are going to buy houses, cash. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I'm simply saying what I'm told to tell you. I'm going to speak to somebody, and this person, you know who you are. Whenever something good is about to happen in your life, you'll have a visitor. Somebody will travel from Africa or from somewhere to visit you. And when one that person goes, everything goes. In 2016, you are not going to be talking to certain people about your investment or what you intend to do. Do not. Because certain things about you is going to take people by storm. Finish reading this.
And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah.
Okay, let's finish it. Thank you. The anointing you've been looking for all these years, you paid money, you've gone to conferences, you've done this, you've paid tithes and offerings and done many things for pastors, for bishops, for prophet, and for all whatnot. You've done this, you've done that for family members, nothing. The anointing that you were looking for will come upon you this year. Finally, the ministry or the business or the marriage that you were looking for, this is the year. God kept it till this year, because I'm going to tell you what you didn't know. While the enemy was putting together an agenda against you 7 years ago, he did not know that God already put an agenda for you long before you were born. See, the agenda of the devil is temporary, while the agenda of God is what? Permanent and forever. You'll never be broke. Because God said to me that he is giving his children the mind of an entrepreneur. Yeah, the mind of an entrepreneur will be given. People of God, I'm going to sit back to watch all this, the videos that has come through this 2016 prophecy. I'm going to sit back because this is very important to me. He's going to link you and he's going to give you the mind of an entrepreneur. That's what is going to happen to you. And for the first time in your life, you will have peace of mind. And that is because this is the year of the Spirit. And until the Spirit of the Lord came upon David, we never hear him. We never hear him being recruited to work in the, WORK. He became a worker in the king's palace until the anointing came upon him. And until the anointing came upon him, he killed Goliath. And until the anointing came upon him, he was able to escape from all the traps and cunnings and lies and death that was put before him. That anointing is upon you tonight. The Spirit of the living God is upon you in 2016 to make you escape from your enemies, escape from death, escape from people who want to kill you, escape from problems. That same Spirit of the living God is going to slay your Goliath. There are some people that God is saying, I should tell you, your problem has been that somebody has been coming from the grave to visit you. Somebody has been coming from the grave. And tonight, the spirit of the ancestors, the spirit of the ghosts has been swallowed, destroyed, chained by the Spirit of the Lord. The people of the grave can no longer come to you, the person on the earth and the person of life. And because it has been dead people, it's because dead people have been visiting you. That's why deadly things have been happening to you. Accident here, sickness there, broke here, evil people being connected to you. But from tonight, the Spirit of the Lord will come mightily upon you, that when you think something is about to make you afraid, who is that? You say, hey, stop it. Hallelujah. And move on in the name of Jesus.
My God, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
For the first time in your life, you are going to enforce authority on the earth. Why? Because the Spirit of the anointing is upon you. This is what God is saying. When you go to God to complain against what your enemy is doing to you, your enemy is putting witchcraft on, God is going to drive you back. He will ask the angels to kick your butt out of the place of prayer and then ask you, what have you done against that enemy? You have the greatest power in the world to command that neighbor to move, and they will move. Don't go to God to go and complain about what the enemies are doing against you. What have you done against them? Have you sat down on the mat for them for 2-3 days and see what will happen? Have you spent some time to fast against them? We are not here for you to pray for mercy. It's for you to pray for God to deal with them, for the spirit of judgment to come against them. Have you done it? And you are here praying, hey, God, change their mind, and they themselves are praying for the devil. Devil, kill this person. This is the year that you are to be made into a champion. Because all the Goliath have received a text message that you are coming. The kingdom of darkness have received a Facebook message, a Google Plus message, a Twitter. Someone has tweeted them that you are coming, that you are already in 2016. So everything that is written in their book, that because it is in October that they are going to start to refresh their thing. So by the time they reach October, they say, hey, don't even start. One wicked prophet from Africa has come to America and has already taken those guys and crossed into 2016. You're wasting your time. One wicked and deadly pastor has already done the harm. So whatever you are trying to do against them will not work. That guy is already ahead of everybody. Don't you know what? Don't you know what the devil calls me? You want to know what the devil calls me? You want to hear what he calls me?
His wife?
Huh? Do you know what they call me from that side? Yeah, they call me the most wicked witch they've ever seen. The most wicked witch they've ever seen. Bell, you want to know what Bell calls me? Bell calls me the most terrible, the most hardened vampire that he has ever seen. I say, you are the one. You are calling me what you are. You see, I'm the most wicked witch they've ever found. Yep. Let me tell you what happened some years back. I did this kind of service some years back. And do you know that everybody who came to this, to the September service that I moved them into the next year in September, you know what happened? Some of their kids who had something on LinkedIn, who had like profile on LinkedIn on Facebook, do you know that people started calling them to come and get a job? One of them actually had a job with Apple without putting in no application. Another one was invited to go and work for, is it Mercedes or whatever? Another one was, I mean, things happens of its own. When you enter into next year in September with me, things come to you of its own. Now, I'm going to share with you what I'm seeing right now. There are certain partners of mine who love a mixture of, this is how it is, that's what I'm seeing right now. They love a mixture of gold and diamond, real diamond and real gold. They love rings. They love rings that are a mixture of gold and diamond. They love necklaces. They like, what do we call it? Is it bracelets? And they like anklets that are a mixture of gold and diamond. Okay. 2016 is the year of the return of your jewelry. Is the year of the return of your jewelry. I'm going to tell you the reason. God is sharing with me right now that many of you, because of the difficulties of the past 7 years or more, many of you sold your jewelries. There are some of you that somebody actually came to visit you, family members, and they stole your jewelries. You know what I'm saying is right. And there are some of you that someone broke your home. They didn't find what they wanted. They thought there was money. And they took your jewelry box. You have not been able to forgive yourself because that was your life. Okay. There's also people who the past 7 years, you had a fire incident that gutted many things that belongs to you. There are some people who are still grieving a particular car that was either repoed or they lost. The people who are. So that is the reason. That's the reason. And there are also people who are still grieving a house that they helped to build or to buy. And it was taken away from you. There are also some of you who are still grieving your kids that was taken away from you and the father is now in charge or the mother is now in charge, things like that. You're still grieving that. You're still grieving that. This is what the Sovereign Lord is saying tonight. This is what he's saying tonight. I am returning back your jewelry to you.
Yes, Lord.
So you are going to, you know, in those days, some of those jewelries actually were fake ones. You know it. You bought what was within your means so as to make you feel good. And that is good, that at least you bought something for yourself. At least that is good. But this is what God is saying. I am going to give you real gold, real diamond. You're going to get the real thing. You asked for a Mercedes, and the guy went and bought you what we call, or you asked for a Caddy or Lincoln or a Pajero or Pathfinder or Nissan or Acura or something. Yeah. Instead, the person that was supposed to get you those things that say he loves you, he went and gave you what we call Ntruma car. You know what we call Ntruma?
Jesus.
Ntruma. He went and gave you Ntruma. You know?
Oh,
he went and gave you Ntruma. Ntruma is the one that when you start it, it looks like 12 people are firing at the same time. So the guy went and bought you an Ntruma vehicle. This is what, because number one, he's cheap. And let me tell you something, God is going to drive away cheap people. You know what I mean by cheap? He's going to drive away all those cheap people away from you. He called them, actually, forgive my word, he called them cheap bastard. Cheap, bloody bastard. He's going to get rid of them out of your life. And also, there are many of you, let me tell you something that you need to know. Many of you who have become victim to all these cheap, bloody bastards. God is saying, I am going to make your heart tough so that you will no longer respond to them. You won't. You won't even have desire. Many of you in 2016 won't even have any desire for sex.
Oh my goodness.
The loneliness that you were feeling will run away from you. The reason is because your job and the good thing will be too good even for you to think about that. So even if the man or the woman were to stand there naked, you won't even look at the person. You'll be on your way.
Oh,
say, hello, I'm on my way to my job. He said, really, honey, can we? Let's get it on. He said, hey, keep it, get it on with yourself. I'm on my way. And by the way, before I come back, pack your things and be on the move because I don't need you here. You've been the biggest distraction in my life. You think I didn't know that you are the witch that has been stopping my progress. You better go. Go and put on your clothes. I don't want to see you are swinging all over this house. Get out from here. Those things, you said to him, those things used to move me in those days. They don't move me no more. Because I now have power over all those things. What makes me feel sweetness is not what is between your legs. Thank you very much. Yep. Yep. And then the person, when I come, you say, no, I don't make love to mentally insane people. You are insane. Thank you. And the guy said, really? You say, yep, because I'm above your class. You are no more my class. I'm no more your class. I've moved ahead. Thank you. You move to your class in the hood or in the shanty town. Leave me alone. I am moving. I have been moved into glory life. Really? You think if you go there, you'll find any man or any woman who is able to make love like I do? You say, get to hell with your love making. To hell with you all. Gav, yeah. Those things used to deceive me in those days. They don't deceive me no more. No more. They don't move me. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Yep. If it is a woman, she stands there shaking her butt all over and everything. And the man is like, those things doesn't move me anymore. No. I need somebody with a big brain, not somebody with a big back. Yep. I need somebody who has power to be detailed in business than somebody who is a sex machine in the bed. No way. I don't need that. It's not working for me anymore. Thank you very much. Nope. Yeah. I'm nobody's sex toy. Thank you. Then, and you add in the name of Jesus. Get. And the person comes to call you, honey. You say, I'm not a bee. B-E-E. So don't call me honey. I don't make no honey. Sweetie, you say, I'm no ice cream. I'm not ice cream. So don't call me sweetie. I'm not cake. Neither am I candy. Don't call me no. I'm nobody's. I'm not your sweetie. Neither am I your honey. Oh yeah. I'm not your ice cream. I'm not your chocolate. No. It's over. I have moved on. It's over. Thank you. And then there was that complaint. I know who has done that to you. Yep. I know. Yep. And he's trying to talk to you, to call you the B word, to call you the, you say, hey, watch it. Because nobody who talks to me that way will get away with it. In the morning, he wake up and his smile has swollen big. Boom.
Oh, my God. Oh, Lord.
This is what the Sovereign Lord is saying. Those who mock you are in trouble. Because this is the year that God Almighty has decided to restore the glory in you.
Amen.
He has decided to restore back your houses. He has decided to restore back your sanity. Because a lot of people have made you not to connect real good. A lot of people. They've done a lot of bad things against you. They've done a lot of bad things against you. That's why somebody is talking. You are not even coordinating. Because of what was done. This is the year of the healing. This is the year of the healing from the depth. The healing of your mind. Because many of you are still stuck in the experience and memory of the marriage that happened, that ended. God is going in his power to bring your spirit and mind back to yourself. Yeah. I know people who are laughing at you today and saying, yeah, she wanted to be on her own. Look at it. If she remained here, it would have at least been good for her. Look at it. But let me tell you something. By the time you start driving that new car that has been put together for you, because 2016 is a package. Please know that. Write that down. It's a package for you. It's a big fat package.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
And let me tell you what is going to happen. Many of you are going to testify about what I'm going to say. You have never received Christmas presents. I'm talking from people. I'm not talking from heaven. You have never received Christmas present as you are going to receive this Christmas. You've never. You've never. That's how you're going to know it. And many of you, for the first time, you will put money in your savings account and you will never touch it for months. That's how you will know. Because trouble, this is what God has told the cherubims. Make sure that trouble doesn't come to this man or to this woman. Because what has made you unable to put money aside has always been when once you get your paycheck, something happens.
Yes, hallelujah.
There's a debt to be paid, or there's a new problem that has started. But God has told the angels, please make sure that problems do not arise anymore in the life of this man or in the life of this woman.
My God.
That is what is going to happen.
Yes, my God. Thank
you. Now, let's pick. Oh, it's getting, what is the time here? Please, somebody should get me. I don't have time before me. What is the time here?
10:52 your time.
Huh?
10:52 your time.
10:52, we have to stop here. We've been here for about 1 hour, 52 minutes. We will not be picking anybody for prophecy tonight. But this is what we want to do. We will pick on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We will be picking people. Tonight was for me to share in depth with you the intimate things that the department that I belong to in heaven shared with me about you. This is the year that I'm going to boast about you. This is for the first time I am going to boast about many of you on the earth. And also, let me share with you what will be happening in our ministry. We will have the greatest turnover of the coming of people. There will be a lot of influx of people coming to the ministry. And many out of you guys that follows, out of you partners, families that follows this ministry, the new staff of the ministry will be coming. It will be coming. Yeah, it will be coming. And I also believe that God is positioning those of us, those in the ministry who are to enter into the millionaire lifestyle, to emerge. It's in 2016. Therefore, you are going to begin to receive thoughts and ideas that doesn't come from you about what you're going to do with you. It's not about money. It's about your gift and your talent and where you should apply for those gifts and those talents to be effectively invested into. That's how 2016 is going to be. This is the day today. We will call this video the day-to-day activities of 2016 in prophecy. Please, Max, remind me about that. The day-to-day activities of 2016 in prophecy. So on Friday, when we will come on Friday, we will begin to expose, we will jump immediately to begin to minister to each of you, prophesy over you quickly, and it will be really quick so that we can cover as many people. Even if it's a million people, between Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we want to finish it up. Please tell people that this is very important. Call your family member, tell them this is an appointment with heaven. We finished the first phase. We are entering the second phase. We are entering the second phase tomorrow, whereby I will begin to speak ring the bell, move into 2016, next person. So I'm going to do that until we are done. And then from Friday, we'll begin the prophecy. We will. It will no longer be take so much longer time because everybody, there's something kicking in with everybody. So it will be quick. The prophetic word will come very swift. It will cut through everything. Bam, and then we go to the next. Bam, and we go until we are done with everybody. So I want to thank you, and I also encourage you to sow a special seed to show your appreciation and gratitude to God for what He's doing in our ministry. God bless you and keep you. I will be on tomorrow by 8 o'clock. I'll be on by 8 o'clock tomorrow to begin taking you into 2016. So on behalf of the Dikai Mary team, Dikai Mary ministry team, I say to you, with God all things are possible, and welcome to 2016. Good night. Beautiful service, beautiful service.